Good evening and welcome to this week's session of Jazz 625, in which we have the Alex Welt Band with a guest soloist, Henry Red Allen. The Scottish trumpeter and band leader Alex Welt moved to London in 1954 to form his own band. He was a dedicated follower of Dixieland jazz with a reputation of excellent playing. The word Dixie was a nickname for New Orleans, and Dixieland derives from the original Dixieland Jazz Band, a white New Orleans group which was successful from about 1917. A Dixieland band's front line would usually consist of trumpet, a cornet, a trombone, and a clarinet, and the music was decorated with colorful and unusual effects borrowed from the black jazz. Welt performed at the Royal Festival Hall on several occasions in the 50s, as well as making frequent overseas tours. The band accompanied many American soloists, including their guest tonight, Henry Red Allen. Henry Red Allen was born in Louisiana in 1908 and learned the trumpet by playing in his father's band in New Orleans. He moved to New York in the early 30s to play in various bands, and by 1932, he had established himself as a leading soloist of the early swing period. In 1937, he worked in Louis Russell's band, accompanying Louis Armstrong. He did not appear quite as comfortable in that role. Accompanist and changing swing style caused him a few problems. In 1940, he left Armstrong and carried on recording and playing. Towards the end of his career, he rejected swing and returned to the New Orleans style of playing, particularly the blues, of which he was an outstanding exponent. He was also underrated as a player, being constantly compared with Louis Armstrong. Allen, however, made the link between New Orleans and later jazz, whereas Armstrong played New Orleans jazz throughout his life. We start, however, with the Alex Welt Band playing Beale Street Blues. Thank you.
Thank you. dear, that I have the fun with you. You told me that you love me, never gave me someone. You made my heart a dream. Yes, I prayed that you'd make it come true. St. James Infirmary. My man Jack T. Gordon played a big part in putting this one on the map. Hey, King Oliver, Bunk Johnson, Buddy Bolin, George Bruner, Swingin' Manon, Tony Perrini, Zuddy Singleton, Louis Russell, Paul Barberin, oh, so many of the boys, Cindy Bashay, Louis Armstrong, they all were there. I was there with them. I couldn't miss. My father had the band, Henry Allen Sr., New Orleans. Found my baby there. She was stretched out on a long white table, so cool, so cold, so fair. Let her go! Bless her. Wherever she may be, she can look this long, wide world all over, but she'll never find another mellow man like me. When I die, high top shoe buttons, real sharp, like my man Phil. On my head, I want a high silk hat. I want a $20 gold piece on my watch chain, so the boys will know I died standing cat. Ha! Sir James! Sir James! Sir James! Ah, Sir James. Everybody! Everybody! went down to St. James Infirmary, second trip. Found my baby there. She was stretched out on a long white table. So cool. All right, let me hear from you up there. Ah. Oh, yeah. It's a number title. Matter of fact, I used to beat this out my father's band when I was around 8, way back, 8 years of old. It's a number title, Just a Closer Walk with Thee. Hallelujah. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4. Watch it, Ellie.
More from Jazz 625 in 2 weeks' time, when the programme features the music of the great saxophonist Ben Webster.